As the national leadership of the ANC arrived at Cooks Lake, a large group of foreign nationals were camping outside the venue. Their situation is desperate.
They are coming to our business and then they are taking everything which is we have. We are staying in the bush. Some of our brothers, they are dying because of the hunger.
We want government must help us. We don't have clothes. We don't have food. Everything, they took it.
The people violence, it doesn't depend on us. We are Ethiopians, we are Pakistans, we are Bangladesh. We are supplying food for the people. Yeah. We are doing a grocery business. We are doing a tax shop business.
Yeah.
We didn't do any crime.
The protests have left a trail of destruction. Those hardest hit are foreign nationals. Their businesses have been looted and destroyed. Police could not prevent it. All this was triggered by a lack of health services.
Hospitals are not working. Clinics are not working. Who is going to help us now? Patients are now being returned from Bopilong Hospital.
Last night, extensive damages were also caused to Mabana head office buildings, where several vehicles were torched. Earlier today, the police minister addressed disgruntled Danville residents after visiting several areas around the city.
Ourselves, we cannot allow our members to mistreat and ill-treat the communities. That's why we'll take the matter up, working with the leadership here, coming together like this, listening more, and taking decisive actions to make sure that our working relationship is much better, is much improved. I'm taking it upon myself. Not only the commissioner will come here, but I will also come back here.
The protests in Mahikeng have spread to other areas across the province. As police have their hands full, it may be some time before affected areas get back to normal. David Lamini, SABC News, Mahikeng.